Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. The paper we're looking at today is a great follow-on to the paper we looked at last week. That paper showed that when trying to adapt an LLM to new domain-specific knowledge, it's better to use RAG rather than fine-tuning. And they had a lot of experimental empirical data to show that. This paper today is looking at a similar question, which is that when you do use fine-tuning, how does that affect the pre-trained knowledge of the LLM that you just fine-tuned? And as the title says, not to bury the lead, when you fine-tune LLMs on new knowledge, it encourages hallucination. This had been a conjecture in the literature and the community for a while, because if you think about it, what you're doing in the process of fine-tuning is essentially telling the LLM to look away from its pre-trained knowledge. And in this paper, the authors actually carry out some experiments to empirically settle this question. So the interesting part of this paper is, how do you construct an experiment to settle this conjecture? The important part of the experiment setup is to come up with a benchmark to test the knowledge of your LLM before and after fine-tuning. And to do that, what the authors have done is construct a set of knowledge in the form of questions and answers, which they classify into four categories. Three of these categories are questions and answers known to the model already, known from its pre-training. And then the fourth category is knowledge that is unknown to the pre-trained model. Within the set of known questions and answers, they further categorize it into three more categories: highly known, maybe known, and weakly known. And this is based on how likely the pre-trained model is to get this question right. Highly known means the model always gets it right. Maybe known means it sometimes gets it right. And weakly known means that you have to fiddle with the temperature parameter to sometimes get it right. And unknown is the set of knowledge that the model has never seen in pre-training and it never gets the correct answer. And then once they have these categories of information, they go ahead and perform different fine-tunings of the model with different percentages of unknown examples in the fine-tuning data set. And this graph shows the headline result from the paper, which is that regardless of how many epochs the model is fine-tuned for, as the percentage of unknown items in the fine-tuned data set increases, the accuracy of the answers suffers. So that begs the question, well, if having a high fraction of unknown samples in the fine-tuning data set is harmful, what if you adjust that mix to have more of the maybe known or highly known data sets? And what they found was that just adding a lot of highly known examples doesn't provide the best accuracy. In fact, having a lot of maybe known examples in the data set gives the best overall performance. And this leads to one of the central ideas of this paper, which is that fine-tuning is not so great at teaching an LLM new knowledge, but what it does is teach an LLM to better utilize its pre-existing, pre-trained knowledge. So to wrap up, the authors in this paper provide some good empirical evidence to show that fine-tuning might not be the best way to teach an LLM new data. In fact, fine-tuning increases hallucinations. And this, combined with the conclusion of the previous paper that I was talking about, really goes to show that RAG might be the best option in most scenarios. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please like the video, consider subscribing, and I will see you all next time. Thank you very much.